So let's create this.
So I have prepared two files for you so you can follow along with this tutorial. And the coolest thing is that this is entirely created in Adobe After Effects without the need of any third-party plugins. So let's get into it. In Adobe After Effects, I'm going to drag and drop my footage into the project manager, and then I'm going to drag and drop this into a new composition. I'm going to fit it up to 100%, and I can see in the playback what I'm doing here. And then next we can import a 3D model. And this is huge for Adobe After Effects. It's a pretty recent release, which is super awesome and gives you endless possibilities without the need of any external plugins. So importing your 3D model is as simple as just drag and dropping it into the project manager. So I'm going to leave my 3D model here for now. We need it later. The first thing that we need to do is actually track my hand. So I'm going to a place where I want the claws to stick out because I'm not going to be using them from the beginning. I actually want them to be animated on. So when I close my hand, I imagine that here I'm going to be closing and then revealing these claws. So I'm going to duplicate my layer by going to edit and duplicate. Then I'm going to trim it until where it starts and then go forward. And then I'm going to trim the end of this footage. So next, what I want to do is just track this part. What I will do is isolate my hand because I just want the tracking data of my hand. Otherwise, the 3D camera tracker is going to try and look at my scene and try to make a 3D map of my scene. I don't want that. So to isolate my hand, I'm just going to solo this layer by clicking here and then double clicking on this layer. That will isolate my layer into a new window. As you can see right here, it says layer. I'm going to choose the RotoBrush 3.0. So I'm just going to select my hand and I'm going to draw something like this at the beginning of my clip. And just clean it up a little bit until you're satisfied you only have your hand and nothing else. Also, make sure that you're working in full resolution. This does make a difference for your roto. So if you're working in quarter, just change it to full while you're doing the roto. It's making a difference. And so I'm just going to hit the space bar, let it go through the entire clip, and then I should have an isolation of my hand, which can get us to the tracking part. So while I'm rotoscoping my hand, let me talk a little bit about PostSpace, because PostSpace.io is an amazing tool if you are a video editor of any kind. It's an all-in-one solution for video production. My most favorite part is that you can upload your footage and you can let it review by your team or by your clients, depending on what situation you're in. In any situation, this is important because getting feedback on your work is what gets you to that next level. Honestly, we didn't get feedback on our own work too much in the past, but right now we are paying much more attention to these things, sometimes resulting on creating a single video and getting like 13 revisions until we consider it done. And that really makes a difference. They also offer some really cool mini apps, which you can try for free. And if you want to find out more about PostSpace.io, I would definitely encourage you to check out the link in the description below, as they are today's video sponsor. Alright, so in the meantime, our hand is isolated and we can continue to the tracking part. After reviewing my shot and considering everything done, I'm going to hit the freeze button here, which is going to freeze this roto and make sure that everything runs a lot smoother as it stops calculating in the background.
Hey, it's me, Editor. Before continuing this video, I wanted to inform you that we had some issues getting consistent track of his hand. So keeping that in mind, we decided to track the whole arm, as you can see right here, to give you the best possible result. You can try with only the hand or continue directly with the whole arm if you are having issues with the tracking tool. All of the techniques shown are the exact same with both selected areas. So don't panic when the footage changes to the whole arm later in the video.
Alright, so now go back to your composition tab and we can see that we have our hand floating around. Now what I want to do is click on this footage, go to layer and click pre-compose. Here make sure that you select move all the attributes to a new composition, rename it to Wolverine hand, and we're going to adjust composition duration to the time span of the selected layer as well. Click OK. Now we need to do one more thing in the background, that's being tracking. So we're going to add a track. So we're going over to the track tab. If you don't see that, you can go over to window, tracker, and open that up. And as you can see, we have a lot of options here. So I'm going to choose the track camera. and just let it do its thing. If it doesn't give you a perfect track, what you can try is open the advanced tab and just check detailed analysis right here. But I found that it's good to try it out in a regular way first. If this doesn't work, go over to the detailed, because I've also found moments when the detailed didn't work and the regular worked, or the other way around. So yeah. If you end up creating something with this tutorial, I would love to see it. So if you post it on Instagram or any other social media, do tag me at Ines Alea. If you don't see the tracking points, it's possible that the track failed, or you just have to increase the point size here. If there are points that you say they shouldn't be in the track, you can simply select them and delete them. And like, for example, right here, we delete this one. And as you can see, we have this big cross here. So obviously something is going wrong, and this is how we optimize our track. So do this a few times until you see like all the points kind of look in a similar size. This is starting to look okay. For example, these big ones, we can still go ahead and delete those because that doesn't make any sense. It seems like they're in a different distance, while in reality, everything is kind of in a similar distance. Okay, so we have our tracking data. I'm going to select these points now and right click create solid and camera. That's going to create a solid. If the solid is not oriented in the correct way, you can simply just rotate this until it does. And you can also add a grid effect to this. This is just reference, we don't really need it. It's just to see if your track worked or not. So if we're going to play this back, we should see pretty solid track. And now it's time to add our class. So as I said, we can now import this directly in Adobe After Effects if it's a .glb or .obj file. The fun thing with the GLB file is that you can include textures. So I'm just going to drag and drop this into a new composition and make the comp size. Just click this button and then click OK. And now you should see them right here. So this is a 3D layer. What I will do is press P on the keyboard for the track solid, that is the position where my hand is supposed to be, and I'm going to click on the position and hold Control and press C to copy the data of the position. Then go to the Wolverine class and press P on the keyboard and click on the position, and now we're going to hold Control and press V to paste all this data. And now we can see that our claws are on my hand. Obviously, they're too small, so I'm going to hold Shift and hold it in the corner, and while holding Shift, we're just going to scale it up to make more sense according to my hand size. Then I'm just going to rotate it into place. So now we have these claws, and you can see they're perfectly tracked. We can actually just make the solid here of the grid invisible so we don't see that. I'm also going to unsolo everything so we can see it on our final look. And we can also move it forward a little bit, maybe scale it even more. That's going to be up to you until you like it. And we can see that the track is really working out for us, so that's really cool. And this is all within After Effects, which is insane. These are my claws, but now we need to animate these on. So to do that, what we're going to do is click on my claws, press P on the keyboard, and create a stopwatch. Then I'm going 2 frames back, just very quickly, and we're going to then position this something like this, so it actually looks like it's going in a straight movement, looking good. And then maybe a little bit later, when you think you're done, I'm actually going to reposition this a little bit because I see it's kind of slipping a little bit, or maybe it's just because it's not perfectly positioned. It looks great now. Again, 2 frames, and then we're going to take this out. So we're just going to position this like this. And now there is one last thing that we need to do. That's to duplicate our original footage and then bring it on top. And here I'm going to add Mocha AE. For the people that don't know what I'm doing right here, this is console effects from Video Copilot. It's completely for free, and it just basically is the effects presets right here, but it's just way faster to work at it. It's exactly the same thing. So if you don't have it, don't worry about it. But I would recommend it though. So we're going to click on Mocha, make sure that you're working in full resolution again, and then go open up by clicking on the logo. And we're going to create a mask of our hands where we want the Wolverine claws to come out. So I'm going to click on the X-Spline tool here, and I'm going to create something like this. So I want them to come out of the top of my knuckles. So maybe something like this should work. And then I'm going to hold Control A, just point these in a little bit. That's going to round these corners. It's going to make it look a little bit better. Once you're satisfied, we can track backwards and forwards depending on where you started. So you will see that this does a pretty decent job at tracking. Okay, so the tracking is done. I'm just going at last frame and readjust the mask a little bit just to make sure it looks nice and neat. That's going to create another keyframe. Everything looks good now. So one thing I want to do before we close this is to create another X-spline. So click on the X-spline again and make a bigger square now, like this. And this is not going to be used for tracking, so we're just going to toggle off the gear icon here. That's basically telling it to take data from your footage. We're not going to do that. We're just going to make it a little bit bigger, and I'm going to link it to layer one, which basically means that it's going to use that tracking data and it's going to follow along. The reason why I'm doing that is to cover up the Wolverine claws. So now we are done and we can save this, and we can open up the mat here and then create AE masks. That's going to create masks from whatever we did in Mocha. Now we can press F on the keyboard, and here on the first mask, maybe set it to like 5. So we have a little bit of feathering going on, so it looks nice and clean. You can also animate the rotation a little bit, because sometimes it might not be perfect. So then in that case, just click on the stopwatch for the orientation and go through your timeline. If you want it to be rotated just a little angle, like more or less, you can do it that way. So then what I want to do is select my camera and select my 3D object, and then go to layer, pre-compose this 3D claws. And now we will be able to add some effects to it if we want to. So I'm going to add a fast box blur, just increase it. That way it's not perfectly sharp, just like my hand. We can also add an exposure to it if you want to brighten it up a little bit. Something like this. And if you want, you can also add curves to it and maybe color grade it a little bit. For example, my scene is more on the reddish tint. So I'm going to add a little bit of red in here. That's just going to match it a little bit better with my scene, I think. The only thing I don't like is that you are actually covering it up with your actual video. So what I will also do is just parent it to this footage, and then I'm going to invert it. So it's actually looking at the footage, but it's transparent. So it's just literally using the clip above it to cut out this part right here. And that's just a cleaner way of working, in my opinion. And then the last thing that you can do is remove your actual points here. To do that, I actually went to the footage where I tracked my hand, and I'm going to open this up. And in this case, I'm not going to create a big square, but I'm just going to create circles around my points here. So I'm just going to zoom in and then create like something like this, and then hold control, right click, control A, and make a nice circle. Make sure it's in the middle of this point and repeat the process. So now that we have all of these, I'm just going to select all of them. And again, we don't need to track here. We just need to add it to the first link of our layer one, which already has the tracking data. So I'm going to close this again, and this time I'm going to click on create masks again, but I'm going to delete all of the masks that we don't need on this layer. So I'm going to select all of these while holding shift. That's going to select all of these circles. Just look at the reference color. Well, actually these should be deleted after. So I'm going to hold control and press X to cut them away this time. And now I'm going to create a new adjustment layer, blur. But before we paste it, make sure that you're at the beginning of your timeline and then paste it. Now we have something like this, and all we have to do is now add a blur. And if you're going to increase the blur until we don't see the points, press F on the keyboard, select all of your layers, and increase a little bit of feather so we don't see an obvious seam. And after all of this, that should bring us to this final result. Enjoy. hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, consider giving a like and also subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. And by the way, if there are any type of videos that you would like to see on the channel, definitely let me know in the comments below. And you know what? Maybe it's gonna be one of my next videos. Apart from that, I hope to catch you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos.